Once again, everybody, you are watching Ash the Kids, the BATZ. Now, make sure you to me, I'm YouTube channel, watch me video. God richly bless you. Yes, this segment I call it SK Beat Filler. The filler that I'm gonna give you is not sending a big baby Hong Kong for in our show. No. This is the filler whereby I get stories from here, from here, from here, from there, from there. And I give it to you to be informed, to be entertained, to have fun. And furthermore, you and I will also be educated as well. And so this is my first time trying this thing. And I want you guys to help me, to encourage me to do more further. So number one, do what to subscribe. Two, do what to like. Three, comment about this so that I know indeed you like it. And the fourth one, in case you are blessed at the end, do it to share with others. Check, my number four. Alright, coming show, one filler of the day I want to share with you is that I was monitoring an exclusive interview between Celestine Donko, gospel female artist, and Ghanaian gospel female artist Celestine Donko, and TV host Giovanni Calib on TV3, Showbiz 360. It's a program that is hosted by Giovanni Calib, yes. So I was watching the interview, and you know, over the weeks, 2-3 weeks now, one of the controversies or one of the issues that are trending is that Celestine Donko has collaborated or featured secular artists in her music, her new track, Aya, title of Thank You. Yeah, that was it. Now, like, why would she, as a gospel artist, feature secular artists? It doesn't work like that. Well, maybe Regina, and I'm never here to judge. The most interesting part is that what inspired her or motivated her to bring the track was that she was COVID-19 positive. Listen, it shocked you.
Why no?
Yeah, Tobo, don't be shocked, Tobo. Well, she was COVID-19 positive. Yes. And she also shared that even though she was COVID-19 positive, out of it all, God was able to do some mighty, wonderful things in her life. Besides, at the moment, currently, Seushiana is through, she has recovered completely.
Why no?
So don't be shocked. Don't go and meet her and let's stigmatize.
Will you keep quiet?
Listen, so right now, no, I want you to listen to the video. I want you to watch and listen to the video so that you get to know what I was really talking about. Okay, so you'll come back.
Mike Babolo, for me, that song is my testimony. Before you do that, I'm sure you hear a lot of people reach out to you on social media about how impactful your ministry has been on their lives.
A lot.
You care to
lot.
Share any of the most profound ones?
Oh, a lot. In fact, one of the comments that started this whole controversy about the song is when somebody said that I don't go to church, but watching this video is really drawing me into Christianity.
You're kidding?
Yeah. You can go on YouTube and check the comments under the video. And one I got yesterday, the guy said, I'm an atheist, but this song is making me feel the presence of God, something like that.
Okay, and things like that just move you to
do
better.
Oh, yeah, and you know, the song is reaching out to people that I have no idea of, you know, and it can be anybody that God is using this song to bless.
You're human. I mean, I said the fact that you're a Levite, you're a minister, a psalmist.
Yeah.
You're human, you have your breaking points. Can you recount any moments where you had to get high on your own supply? Like, you heard your own song, you'd be feeling this depressed. Shouldn't be feeling this down. It's like, doctor, you have medication there, but you now, one day, you're like, this headache, I'm not sure to say paragraphic. Yeah. Do you have moments like that?
Oh, yeah, a lot of times. Mm. A lot of times.
Pressure on you, you're broken.
Yeah.
You cry out.
A lot of times. We encounter things that break us, you know, a lot of them. And
what keeps you
going? The recent one that comes to mind is that during the Christmas season, I was going through COVID.
Whoa.
Yeah, I was down with COVID. And imagine an artist who has pushed my song for the whole year. And you know,
when you're supposed to be
when
out
I'm
there
supposed
performing.
And I was actually, I had lined up bookings for programs and I had to call back and disappoint the event organizers because.
Yeah, you had COVID.
Yeah.
We shouldn't fight stigma, but. Well, how long ago was this? How long ago was this?
I've fully recovered
now. I know. Kakro. Which, please don't stigmatize anybody, okay? COVID is real. Faculty, I play music too. Switch of hosts, ladies and gentlemen. No. But this is a survivor story. I no wonder. Yeah. That's why I thank you. No, you were singing the bass at the back and backing yourself.
I tell you,
because it's a testimony for you.
Yeah,
Papa.
You know,
you've been through things.
I know what I've been through.
Was it that bad?
Yes. It was. I hardly fall sick for like 20 years. I stay in without even para.
What?
Yes,
but COVID is like a mule vis-a-vis.
It really dealt with me, and I came out loud to say that actually this COVID is no joke. Mm. It's no joke at all. And all these things happened to me. Some of these event organizers, they paid, you know, upfront. We have to refund. Yeah. This is the only, you know, big downtime that comes to mind.
I know.
And we have gone through all this, and I'm here today.
You're a testimony.
I don't look like what I've been through.
No, you don't.
So allow me to thank God.
Thank God for your life.